Welcome to my new video. Today I will show you a little project I just did. It took me like 5 to 10 minutes. I just looked around for some cool percussion loops, and I found this one. It's really simple, just some hi-hats and some really small percussion. And I also found this one. The original loop goes like this. But yeah, I didn't like the rest of the loop, so I just cut it without, so it just got this. And I added a kick and I got this. And yeah, it's a pretty cool beginning to a track, so I wanted to show you with this video how I build up my tracks from scratch. And this may seem hard for beginners or people who have lost inspiration, and I will try to teach you how to get some inspiration and how I build my tracks. So I also found this bell. And I thought for myself, that sounds pretty cool. I mean, you can use crashes for breaks and stuff, but why not use a bell? So this is what I've been coming up with so far. And fast forward. And it gives the track that that evil kind of evil spirit, evil beat. And I think it suits so well for this track. It has that tribal feeling, so sounds pretty cool. So what I want now, or what I usually add, is a sub bass, because it's the foundation of all underground house tracks. So let's add a good sub bass to this. Well, let's just clone this one and add Silenth. We can use Silenth, and I actually have a sub bass preset. It's nothing special, it's just a really round and a clean sub bass. You can also do it in a 3x oscillator like I did in my last video. So yeah guys, let's create the sub bass. Let's find some good notes for this one. Maybe can like can use G. Yeah, that sounds pretty cool. And what we want to do now is to bind the sub bass to a mixer channel and then link it to the kick, so we can add some side chaining, some compression. So what you want to do is click on a kick and click on little arrow, and it's linked. So go into sub bass, open the limiter, click compression, add sidechain 1. Lower the threshold and upper the ratio. It's the basic rule. And we have some basic sidechaining. And you can also play around with these settings to get the like perfect sidechaining. You can play around with attack and such, but I won't go into too much detail in this video. So now when we got a nice sub bass, we can add it on the small bell drop, and this is what we got. It's kind of moving, but I don't like the notes on this one, to be honest, too much. So let's find better notes. Yeah, it is pretty cool, and we get different frequencies with the sub bass. So now it's time for the stab. I mean, the stab, I use a stab in all my tracks, and sometimes it's made in Silenth, like a basic cutoff stab, and sometimes I use a sampled stab. And today I'll use a sampled stab because it's the easiest way out, right? And some producers are like, I can't use samples, blah blah blah. But I mean, you can use samples, it's not a big deal, as long as you don't like sample a whole track. That's kind of lame. So what I like to do is to just unleash my creativity on some random samples. So let's find a good stab. This kind of evil, and it actually fits our track, so let's use this. Like this maybe. Yeah, and always open your sabs in Granulizer so you can play notes with them. Like that. Now let's add some ambience, some reverb to it, and yeah, I use ambience. It's my favorite reverb plugin at the moment. But you can use whatever you want. You can use the fruity reverb if you like. Let's add some EQ to not interfere too much with the bass frequencies. But I'm not sure if I like this one, so let's find another one. This could be pretty cool. Let's reverse it. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Aha, yeah, it's really cool actually. So what we can do now is to clone it and to reverse it so it gets to the main how it was before. And it was reversed, so we can play around with that, see what we get. Copy the little melody. And we can redo it. It's a little bit too fast, so let's switch it up. Yeah, something like that. It's a little bit too late, I think. Let's find a good... Yeah, that's pretty cool. And you also noticed I cut a little bit out of the bell and did a little bit of a little rise with it. So if you listen closely here. Just to give the beat some variation. I can hear now that that the stab isn't the key, so that kind of sucks. Yeah, that sounds a bit, little bit better. Let's add some compression and sidechain on our stab. So you probably know how to do it. And now always move your limiter or sidechaining plugin to the to the top because it has the highest priority over everything, and then the EQ, and then the reverb. And you do this with a scroll wheel, so you can just blah blah blah, you know, you can just scroll around with it. Another thing I value really, really high is the filters. The simple low, what's called, low cutoff filter. Because I don't like to just pop in elements in the track, I like to like sneak them in to get that real fluid sound of the song. So we could add some filtering to the stab. So let's do that. Normally use the Just Fruity filter. Take the this to on because it just gives a better sound. Lower the resonance and the high pass, and we have a filter. So just right click on the cutoff and click create automation clip, and you're set. And we can actually sneak that in already from the beginning. Like that. We can also do an automation clip on the ambience, just to give that drop feeling. So open your ambience, click here. You first have to just select the wetness of the reverb. Click here and browse parameters, and right click on the wet gain and automate it. So let's do that. Now I usually do it like one block before the drop, and then I lower it again, just to give that big feeling before the drop. Yeah, it sounds pretty cool. Because if you do this, if you do the big reverb before the drop and then just tighten it up on the drop, you will get that really close like clubby feeling, and before you will get that euphoric feeling, and that's exactly what you want to do. You want the people to just feel really euphoric before the drop and just doot doot doot, and when the drop hits they want to get real, everything needs to sound dry, and yeah, it sounds really good if you do that, so do that. Another thing you can do with your loops before the drop, you can add some filter to them just to make the drop even bigger, so it hits even harder. So let's do that. Let's add some filters to our sweep. Automate it like this, and add a filter on our main loop. And do the same thing. Just you can create a little dot here. And just lower it before a drop, and then high, make it high on a drop, so it goes like. Like that. And you have a real nice moving track. Sounds really groovy, and that's exactly what you want to do, or you want it to feel really groovy. And what we can do now is to play around with it even more. Maybe add another drop, like a small break here inside the drop, and make it more progressive. So yeah, we can add another bell and we can copy this automation on the bell to make it the same on the other side of the drop. So right click here and click make unique, and what this does is it allows you to copy the same automation and paste it somewhere else. If we would have done it with, for example, this automation that isn't made unique, you will see that if you move it here, it will move on the other side too, So you don't want that to happen. You just want to make it unique so you can like... Or wait, it does that. cut. That's wrong. Sorry. You have to right click on the one you copied and make it unique also. And then you can move this around without affecting the other automation. So yeah. So now we can make another small drop inside the drop with some added symbols and some progression simply. So what I like to do is to just remove the kick on like the last square before the second drop inside the drop, and do a small like reverb gain or something for the synths, just to make it so the people can feel that something is happening to their beats. And then make it dry again on the second drop. Like, if you can make a whole track just by doing this, it like lightens up the track and makes it unique in some kind of way. So what we can do now is to add some cymbals, some open hi-hats to be specific. Damn, I can't talk. So let's find some open hi-hats. Let's see here. I have to browse some samples because I don't know which one to use. Let's see. Yeah, this is a really simple 909 hi-hat. We can use this one for now. And to make the track even more fuller and make it more acoustic in some kind of way, you can pan things around these dots here. It decides if one sound will pan to the right or to the left. I can show you. For example, with a stab. Now it's on the right there. And if you pan to the left, it's on the left there. So we can pan it a little bit to the left just to give the track some space. So yeah, this is the basics I use for every track I produce. I mean, I always start out with a loop or maybe a stab, and I build my way from there and just add to the track, make the drops even bigger. And now we have already started with a drop, so what you can do is just to like extend it and make the intro a little bit bigger. And yeah, that's about it. It's not it's not harder than that actually. So I really hope you learned something from this. And if you have any question, anything, drop it in the comment section below, and I will answer any question. So, I hope you enjoyed, and see you in the next one. Lucas out.